Ladies and gentlemen, Hillary Clinton is running for president 2020. Every action shows that she is already currently running. In fact, she's the leader in the 2020 race. She just hasn't announced it yet. Hillary Clinton is sending out feelers to her supporters via email. The New York Post is reporting it, considering and testing a 2020 run. 2 years ago, a year ago, 6 months ago, and just a few weeks ago, I came out on air and in articles at NewsWars.com and InfoWars.com and said from my sources inside the Democratic Party, but also inside the Secret Service and other security groups, Hillary Clinton is still planning to run for president in 2020. Now, a lot of people said, that's crazy. She'll never do it. She lost the election. The Democrats hate her. The voters hate her. All this corruption's come out on her. And I said, listen, I've been told by the Secret Service, the same group that told us that Hillary had a black ambulance and that she was collapsing and that she was having convulsions, all of that was later confirmed. I've been told that in meetings, she's still running the DNC through her foundation, and that she is still calling the shots. And so I said, bare minimum, she wants to collect all the money that's coming into the Democratic Party. And sure enough, now she's having big fundraisers for the DNC and keeping the lion's share of the money and turning heads. And now it's all over Fox. It's all over CNN. They're saying, is Hillary Clinton planning to run? And now they're saying, uh-oh, looks like Hillary Clinton is planning to run.
So will she give us what we want?
So let's walk through the evidence that she's already currently running. She has come out and not endorsed any other candidate in the last year, even though she's been asked this hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times.
Have you endorsed anyone?
No, I'm not going to.
No. Mm-mm.
Number two, she's been holding fundraisers all over the United States, and she continues to keep her foundation open and operating and taking donations from individuals that have given her money for pay-per-play in the past. Now let's look at point number three, which is important, but not as important as points four and five that I'll get to in a moment. Point three, look at the lay of the land. Look at the political climate. Look at how no real heavy hitters have run and how the Democrats are raising less than half the money they raised under Obama the last two times. The big money just is not putting it on the line because they believe these candidates are lightweights. Now, why is that? Why wouldn't some of the other heavyweight candidates that are out there jump in? Because, ladies and gentlemen, they know that these other candidates are simply there to raise money for the DNC and are placeholders for Hillary. And that leads us to point number four, which is very critical. The Secret Service and other security individuals that have been at the houses, at the buildings, in the meetings in New York, in the meetings at her houses at D.C., in the meetings with the Democrats, say that it's well known that Hillary still thinks she can run and still thinks she can win. Now, she may get sick. She may still secretly drop out. But that's real intel, ladies and gentlemen, that she's still in control of the party. She's running the lawsuits against me through Democrat law firms. She's still controlling the media. She still travels around the country giving speeches and having events like she's running because she is running. The only thing she hasn't done is announce it. Now, let's look at number five. Don't you see it? She thinks that if she has all these weak candidates running, they drop off one by one, that at the right moment she slips in at the convention while President Trump is under impeachment in the House and then facing a trial in the Senate. She believes one way or another that a weakened Trump at that level may be forced to drop out. In comes Pence. She's got all her intelligence ops still in control of the agencies. She's got her election fraud, her illegal aliens, people voting the names of dead, and that will be enough to take her over the top. And that is the plan that they've laid out. That's clearly what they're doing right now. Now, I don't know if this plan is going to work, but Hillary Clinton has proved that she is a political survivor. She has proved that she has a lot of will, and she's certainly shown that she still believes that she's going to be president in 2020. Again, InfoWars.com is truly next year's news today. I have been on record since she lost saying that she still plans to run again. And then about 2 years ago, the sources that are very good sources began to say, oh, yeah, she fully intends to run again. And now mainstream media is saying, well, looks like the other candidates aren't doing well. Bernie's had a heart attack. He's going to have to drop out. Joe Biden's raised less money than the other three top candidates combined. Looks like he's got some kind of neurological problem. What are we going to do? And then in slips Hillary at the last moment. So there isn't all this political scrutiny of her past. And she believes, like the dark horse, she's going to win. The stars are aligning for this. People better get ready. I'd give it about a 90% chance that she's going to announce sometime next year while Trump's under impeachment and has a good chance of getting in through fraud. So you've been warned. We were the first to tell you. Now it's mainstream news that it looks like Hillary's going to run. InfoWars, next year's news today. That's why they don't want us on air. While we're censored off YouTube, Google, Twitter, Facebook, everywhere. But this is important information, so please take this, re-upload it, share it, email it, Facebook it, Twitter it, share it from band.video. That site isn't as blacklisted as much. And just please raise the alarm as modern Paul reveres. Because despite all their attacks, InfoWars has stayed on the air so that we can continue to get this vital information out. That's why it's critical we stay on air, because the globalists know that we've done our homework, we've got the sources, and that we continue to break the stories that are bringing down the criminal deep state. Thank you all for watching. Again, please share this important report and join me for the Sunday show, 4 to 6 p.m., as we do every Sunday evening and weekdays at 11 a.m. Central at InfoWars.com and band.video and radio and TV stations across the country. Again, God bless you and God bless the United States of America. May we all pray that Providence stops Hillary from getting into office. Thank you.
A lot of people ask, why do big corporations like to have little lovable mascots? You know, Disney, it's Mickey Mouse. You've got the gecko for Geico. You've got the emu for Liberty Insurance. Well, it's because they want to look like they're non-threatening, kind of like a child molester. It's like, hey, look, I got toys. I'm nice. I'm friendly. I'm not saying those companies are child molesters, but I'm saying it's kind of the same strategy that they're non-threatening. So they'll sit there trying to make you think that they're the real McCoy, because they've got some CG computer generated system of a fake lizard or a fake emu or whatever the case is. So here you go, ladies and gentlemen. You've got the fake llama, kind of like the fake news media, and then you've got the real llama. And here you go, ladies and gentlemen. Real llamas for your edification. You got the fake llama, you got the real llama. And it really comes down to what is the real llama and what is the fake llama. Now, this one seems to be settling in over here and enjoying itself. How are you doing? Do you like the toy? And I was talking to this llama's mommy earlier, and she was telling me they don't give them fluoride water because that kills horses and llamas and things. So that's just one of the reasons we thought today that we would talk about. It's important to know what the real McCoy is versus a fake. InfoWars is for real. It's why they're trying to shut us down. We're not a plastic llama. Trump's for real, what he's trying to do. That's why they're trying to shut him down. So always look for the real thing, ladies and gentlemen, and not the fake thing. Fake llama, real llama. CNN fake news, InfoWars real news. And that's a real llama, okay? All right, InfoWars.com, tomorrow's news today.